So, as you might have noticed, I'm not from Arizona. I'm from Arkansas. I grew up in a small town called Bay. It's about as big as its name. There's around 3,000 people there. And I lived in Bay for about 18 years. I was raised predominantly by my single mother. My mother is the most inspirational person in my life. She was profoundly intelligent, humorous, creative, passionate, kind, and loving. She excelled in many things. She was a flight attendant, an interior designer, a seamstress, a nanny, and even a surgical technologist. And as a young child, I fondly remember her nights when she was on call for surgery. We would be called in, and I would get to wear scrubs and a mask and gloves and watch TV, and she would hide me in the doctor's lounge, which I thought was really cool. And I could watch their big TV, and I even ate their donuts, and maybe one too many, but it was great. It was great. I thought I was something else. But more than that, I really remember the feeling of knowing that my mother was doing something amazing. She was saving someone's life, but you don't get called into surgery in the middle of the night for no reason. So it really, I was proud of her. And unfortunately, just as much as my mother excelled, she also, in her various undertakings, she suffered from moderately progressive neurological and neuropsychological illness. In Arkansas, some people, unfortunately, even medical professionals, they call that crazy. As a child, I knew there was a better explanation. So I became fascinated by neuroscience. In fact, I told everyone I wanted to be a neurologist, and thankfully, I smartened up. Now, I know a lot of amazing neurologists, and I'm poking fun at them at their expense. I do love them dearly. So having a neurological and a mental illness in a place like Arkansas, it's a great hardship. As my mother's illness is synergistically progressed, she was unable to work. Epileptic patients are not lawfully permitted to drive, we lived about 10 miles from the nearest grocery store in a rural area void of public transportation. Needless to say, my struggling yet determined mother didn't always follow the law. So we won't speak any more about that. But I remember some times when my mother would run out of her medications, groceries, be unable to afford rent or utilities. Before graduating high school, I had moved countless times, lived with both grandparents, and spent the last part of my senior year living alone to ensure that I would graduate with a high school diploma. Despite all of that, I graduated at the top of my class, and on my college applications, I was sure to mention that I was a valedictorian. I just didn't mention there were only 30 people in my class. So that's a perk of growing up in a small rural community, I suppose. Despite my mother's progressing illness, she infused within me a hunger for knowledge and empowered me with the truth that I could do anything. She wanted most that I pursue a higher education. I was the first individual from my mixed Southern Hispanic, that's quite a combination if you don't know, family to attend college. In 2001, I was offered the prestigious Rhodes Award from Rhodes College. However, as my CV notes, I respectfully declined this award. The truth is, I didn't even know what it was, and I didn't think that I, an impoverished teen, could attend such a prestigious institution. So instead, I moved to Tennessee, and I attended a small community college. By this time, I knew I wanted to enter healthcare, a profession in which I could make a difference in the lives of so many families like my own. Moreover, I needed a profession that I could earn an income to support my educational pursuits while helping my mother. And nursing provided me with the opportunity to do all of that. I was able to earn an income as a neuroscience nurse intern while I pursued my associate's degree. And after earning my degree and my RN license, I became a charge nurse of that same neurosciences unit. After gaining experience as a neuroscience nurse, I accepted a travel position at prestigious Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore. And in 2008, I relocated here to Tucson when we opened the Carondelet Neurological Institute. Meanwhile, I became a certified neuroscience registered nurse and a stroke certified registered nurse. I'm a little bit of a neuro nerd, but I'm proud of it. So, meanwhile, my mother's illnesses steadily progressed. It was not uncommon to get periodic phone calls that she was hospitalized or had attempted to harm herself. When you have a loved one with moderate to severe mental illness, you start to fear those late night or early morning phone calls. Sometimes there's that one call, and it comes like a cannonball. And you see it coming, but you don't know when it will hit, and you don't know what you can do to stop it. I got that call on June 1st, 2010. My mother, Melanie Rogers, age 44, had taken her own life. Upon receiving the call, I fell to my knees, and I felt an agony unlike any other. And to this day, the memory flashes before my eyes and takes my breath away. I felt alone and defeated in that moment, and inevitably I questioned all that had become. I, a neuroscience nurse expert, could not help the one person I wanted to help the most. And I thought, if I cannot help my own mother, then who can I help? And did I choose the wrong path? So thankfully, after I realized that more than ever, I must continue on my path of service for patients like my mother and families like my own. And I was convinced that I must not let the gravity of the health disparities that we had encountered deter me from passionately pursuing their amelioration. Because if I wasn't going to help, then who was? So 6 months later, I was applying to University of Arizona College of Nursing, Doctorate of Nursing Practice Program, to become an adult gerontology acute care nurse practitioner. Gerontology, so we do have we cover all kinds here. So there are quite a few programs across the country offering distance education for DNP students. I chose this university because I wanted to align myself with a respected and high-ranking institution. Additionally, I was interested in alternative therapies for neuroscience patients. When I first browsed the website here at the U of A, I noticed a media spotlight on Dr. Taylor's research for the Tai Chi for Stroke Survivors research study, and I thought, this is perfect. Here's a well-respected college of nursing in my own backyard offering research in the exact areas of research that I'm interested in. And so in the second semester of my program, I mustered up the courage to talk to her, and I expressed interest in her research. And on her first meeting, she told me, we're going to write an abstract, and we're going to take it there. And she pointed to this sign on her door, and it was for the American Heart Association's 2013 International Stroke Conference. And I said, we like you and your colleagues? And she's like, no, like we like you and me. And I said, oh, me? And she said, yeah. So okay. So I left her office, and I was really excited. And I got into my car, and I immediately pulled out my smartphone, and I Googled, what is an abstract? Because I needed to know. What I just agreed to. I knew it was something good, but I was like, I better find out what I need to do here. So from then on, she became my mentor and my advisor, and she patiently took me under her wing. Obviously, I was clueless. And often her confidences in my abilities, they exceeded my own. I completed independent studies with her and became a volunteer member of her research team. And we did go to Hawaii. With Dr. Taylor Piliai's help, I authored two abstracts and won American Heart Association's New Investigator Travel Award. Additionally, our abstract scored among the top 10% of all abstracts submitted to the International Stroke Conference, and we were invited to present our work in Dallas at American Heart Association's 2013 Best of Scientific Sessions. So in December, I completed my Master's of Science in Nursing, and in February, I became a board-certified adult gerontology acute care nurse practitioner. That's a mouthful, but I own it. So last month, I accepted a position as Grand Isle Health Network's first doctorally prepared nurse practitioner, and in 10 days, I'll defend my doctoral practice inquiry. Next month, I will graduate with my DNP, and I'll transition into my new role. So the road I've traveled from there to here, it's been long, but I know it's not been in vain. I truly love what I do, and I cannot wait to bring all that I have and learned and become to service. And though I wouldn't really wish my challenges on anyone, I wouldn't trade their lessons learned for an easy road. Through my tragedies, I have experienced the blessings of purpose, passion, love, and hope. All that I have endured and overcame has cultivated within me a resilience and a future of inevitable success, because I truly believe this, that when you believe in something, a cause, and you fully commit yourself to it, the universe conspires to make it so. So I thank you for empowering me to make it so. And when life told me, no, you can't, your belief and the blessing of your generous support often told me, yes, you can. Know that the gifts that you give are sometimes the one thing telling a struggling yet hopeful student that yes, you can. And so I thank you for giving, and I promise to make you proud.